Hello and welcome to the episode 95 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Some of the highlights of the day include the Beatles' first silver disc, the Fabs' first encounter with Indian music, and a birthday surprise. Let's see. On the 5th of April 1961, we find the Beatles with Pete Best on drums performing another night of their residency at a top 10 club in Hamburg, West Germany. 1 year later, in 1962, the Beatles, still featuring Pete Best, played an evening concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. The Cavern had been reserved by the band's manager Brian Epstein, and the concert, also featuring the Four J's as support group, was a special event reserved to the members of the Beatles Fan Club. For the first half of their performance, the lads wore again their rough-looking black leather jackets, but after the intermission, they walked on the stage with their new, idiosyncratic suits. By all accounts, it was a nice party, with club owner Ray McFall singing two Elvis songs with the Beatles, the band performing Pinwheel Twist, see episode 82 of What a Fab Day for more information on that song, with Paul McCartney on drums, and Pete Best twisting in front of the stage with his girlfriend, and things like that. 1963. In the afternoon, the Beatles gave a private performance to EMI record executives during a ceremony at the EMI House in London. The ceremony was meant to celebrate the band's first silver disc, received for breaking the 250,000 sales landmark for the Please Please Me single. According to Beatles historian Mark Lewson, the day was rounded up with an evening performance at the Swimming Baths in Leyton. On the 5th of April 1964, the Beatles and the crew of the Hard Day's Night film were at the Marylebone station in London to shoot the opening sequence of the film. The shootings were arranged on Sunday afternoons when the station was closed to the public. The scenes in which the Beatles are seen chased by fans were realized with the help of more than 100 extras, duly paid £7.10 each, about £150 in 2020 money, for a job that they would have gladly done for free. In 1965, the Beatles were at the Twickenham Film Studios to continue the shooting of their second feature film, Eight Arms to Hold You, later renamed Help. Today, the band worked on the sequence of the interior dining area and the kitchen of the Rajahama restaurant. This was the first time the band was exposed to Indian classical music. In an article in the December 1992 issue of Billboard, quoted on BeatlesBible.com, George Harrison recalled, "I remember picking up the sitar and trying to hold it and thinking, this is a funny sound. It was an incidental thing, but somewhere down the line I began to hear Ravi Shankar's name. The third time I heard it, I thought, this is an odd coincidence. And then I talked with David Crosby of the Byrds and he mentioned the name. I went and bought a Ravi record. I put it on and it hit a certain point in me that I can't explain, but it seemed very familiar to me. A few months elapsed and then I met this guy from the Asian Music Circle organization who said, oh, Ravi Shankar's gonna come to my house for dinner. Do you want to come too? On the 5th of April 1967, Paul McCartney, accompanied by Beatles assistant Mal Evans, flew to Denver, Colorado from San Francisco to surprise his girlfriend Jane Asher on her 21st birthday. Asher was touring the States with an Old Vic Theatre production of Romeo and Juliet. Paul and Asher were reunited in the evening and attended a hotel birthday party in her honour. Finally, in 1970, Ringo Starr was interviewed for BBC Radio 1's Seen and Heard by Johnny Moran. The show was broadcast live between 3 and 4 p.m. If you're curious about the content of the interview, you can listen to it following the link in the episode description. Please notice that the linked page says that the interview was given to David Wigg, but BBC's On Record clearly states that it was Johnny Moran who conducted it. And this concludes another episode of What a Fab Day. If you are fab, and you are, please visit www.simonmas.com/support to help me to improve the quality of my music-related content and keep it free for all. As you will see, you can do a lot, even without parting with your money. Tomorrow never knows. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.